Everyone.
Good morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Okay, can we all, to all my D1 family members, can we just mute our microphone, right? So, right, that's great. Okay. How are y'all? Hope all are doing very well, right? I'm actually outstation. They're quite busy, right? Traveling here, there for programs, right? Okay, anyway, today I'm going to talk to y'all about money. Money and me. Now, this program is for some special group of people, right? I travel around the world. This question comes to me, and I've been thinking about it. You all know that? I'm thinking about it. You join in this business for various reasons, but one of the fundamental reasons is basically to make money. So this program simply goes as a title with money and me. I mean to you. The simple logic of this program, right, is to make you comfortable with the concept of making money through network marketing, through Destina One, and for you to fundamentally understand what financial freedom truly about. Because it seems to be various theory which I've met group of people, you know, which totally they have taken concept of financial freedom and they flip it totally upside down, right? Firstly, let us clear one fundamental moral issue here. That having strong desire for money is not wrong. It's normal. It's normal. I think everyone on this planet, unless you are planning to go to Himalaya mountains and stand in one foot for the rest of your life, right? It simply means that wanting money and having a desire to have a better life is normal. It's what we all want. That is the reason we all join Destina One. And in network marketing, I think many organizations emphasize the fact of financial freedom that come. One, you got to buy a Mercedes, you got to buy a Rolls Royce, you got to buy a mansion, you got to buy a private jet. That's the aspect of network marketing, which I think it's very attractive for a common man and a common woman with an uncommon dream. I was thinking about this, you know. Basically, you go through life surrounded by influence that money is important. How many of you have grown up with rich uncle, rich, very rich neighbor, right? Or richest man in your village? Can you just turn off the microphone? Is that? Give me a minute. Let me help them turn off their microphone. Okay, right. So basically, you all went through this kind of life, with surrounded with a lot of rich people, a lot of rich uncle and all these things, right? Which you looked up and say, wow, I want to be like him, right? Definitely, you have went through this life. Wow, I want to drive that car. I want to have everything that he has, right? Unless you grow up in a protected environment or different sets of moral standing. I come from the town called Butterworth, where a Mercedes is something commonly saw. So in my town, we had a doctors, a lawyers who drive Mercedes. Now, as a young kid, I was riding a bicycle or walking or running. When you saw that Mercedes Benz, it naturally clicked in your mind that, hey, one day I want to drive this car. Right? There's nothing wrong with it. Correct? So when people talk to me about network marketing and why they come into network marketing, everyone talk with a little bit of guilt. Guilt of wanting to make money. They even say the word money a bit softly. You know that? Have you seen anyone? I want to make money. I want to make money. I want to be rich. You see, when come to money, rich, and all this, they say softly. They don't want to even hurt that particular thing. Can you see that? Right? So in a very soft tone, you know, right? So firstly, get over that hurdle. Firstly, get over that hurdle. I'm Dr. Barney Karunakaran, and I'm not afraid to say that. I have a huge dream to make lots of money at the point I don't know what to do with it. Why when it comes to money, everyone, I want to make money. But you know how they say, I want to make money. I want to become rich. Very softly, they say that money and rich. They feel very allergic with the word. Right? You feel very allergic with the word. But you should not get rid of that hurdle, man. Right? So what I'm trying to say, the most important thing, okay? Of course, having a huge dream to make a lot of money at one point, it will become a driving force for you. It will become a driving force for you, right? Because money is neutral. It's not good, it's not bad. People are bad and good. See, if you give $10 million to Mother Teresa, she's going to do a good things with it. If you're going to give this money to a crook, he's going to do bad things with it. So, firstly, understand that having a desire for a better life, having a materialistic life, dreams is acceptable. It's acceptable. As long as you get it using the right method. Remember that. You get it using the right method. That's why I fell in love with network marketing. The reason why I love Destina One, I love the philosophy of network marketing because firstly, it doesn't judge you. You can be black, white, brown, green. You still have an equal chance of making money in network marketing as long as you put in the effort and work hard. So people who came into network marketing suddenly feel under tremendous amount of pressure in their shoulder. You know that? When they come into network marketing, they start to feel a tremendous pressure on their shoulder. If they don't make money, you're absolute failure. Now, don't isolate network marketing as a standalone concept. If you look into network marketing, it falls into a bigger set. It's a subset within a set of business ownership. So let's forget network marketing for 30 seconds and look at traditional business. Now, in the traditional business, you get into for what? To make money also. Whether it's a restaurant, it's a pet shop, it's a hotel, it's a retail shop, a tailoring shop, whatever you own. You started with the purpose of making money. When you enter any form of business, there is a huge area of uncertainty. Right? Uncertainty, you don't know what is going to happen, which will decide how much money you make. So I cannot guarantee you, if you open a restaurant, you are going to make $1 million in the first month. I cannot guarantee you. Equally, I cannot guarantee you if you join Destina One tomorrow, you're going to make $1 million in the next first month. Of course. But both traditional business and Destina One business require certain principles which allows you a better chance or higher percentage of making a lot of money. Of course, you can make $1 million. But of course, there is a time matter. That's why I always say to my people, there is a time matter. It's just a time matter. Right? So it requires certain principles. So today's program, Money and Me, I'm going to talk to you all about what is required for you to become successful in whatever you do, especially in Destina One. So think about it. Every journey you start here and your destination is there, right? You start here and your destination is here, right? First, you have to decide your destination. You have to decide your destination, where you want to go. This is something that some of you write down, no? You know, some of you, they write down as a dream, as a goal, as things that you really want out of life, but it's not clear. A lot of people, see, the problem is what, you know, they know that they want to become rich. They wanted to be a millionaire. They wanted to become filthy rich. They wanted to become financially freedom. But the problem is not clear. They're not clear. So wake up, guys. You all have to be crystal clear in your mind what you want. What do you want? If you're not crystal clear in your mind what you want, then your journey can be highly confusing. See, you'll go to a shop, you want to buy a Mercedes Benz. When you want to buy a Mercedes Benz, you will choose which class that you want to buy, A class, C class, S class, E class. Am I right? You cannot go and tell them that, I want to buy a Mercedes Benz. So, sir, which class you want? I don't get, but I want to buy a Mercedes Benz. You see? So, I'll tell you one thing, the journey can be highly confusing. Do you understand? Because if I know I want to reach that point right over there, all right, I know I just have to walk straight, which should be the shortest distance to reach the point. But if I'm not sure what I want to get there, then I can walk many places upside down, turn here, turn there, and everything. And of course, I don't reach to my destination. You see? Correct? People who join Destina One, get into network marketing, just have a high level of uncertainty what they want. Remember, if you don't know what you want, you don't know what to do. If you don't know what you want, you don't know what to do. Remember that. If you don't know what you want, you don't know what to do. Again, I'm telling y'all. I'm reminding y'all. So, you do a lot of things. You don't know what to do. What? So, what do? You do a lot of things. You'll be talking to people. You'll be signing up people. You'll be selling product. Some of these diseases, how to use the product. How? Even to all the uplines, how to use this product for this disease. Come on. For all the disease, the way to use the product is simple. Hey, wear the pendant, drink the flask water, take Scalavia, take Scala AFA, possible you drink coffee, finish, that's all. No need to prescribe how many, what to do and all this. Whatever your heart says, tell them. Sometimes your heart might say, wear 5 pendant. Okay, wear 5 pendant. How many drop? Drink 1 bottle of Scalavia every day. Go drink. Whatever your intuition say, go and tell that. Go and tell. Whatever your intuition say, go and tell that. No need to like get a prescription from a doctor or Alex or Don or Arul or all these people. Whatever your intuition say, go. Do it. Because you're doing something good. Definitely your intuition will say the right thing. Right? So remember, most important thing, people who's watching this video right now, in your living room, with your downlines, with your uplines, please be crystal clear what you want. And don't be afraid to dream money, material. Don't be afraid. Well, if you want a Mercedes, make it a Mercedes. If you want to buy a private jet with yellow pink dots or pink jet with yellow dots, I really don't care as long as it is crystal clear. It is quantifiable. Quantifiable. You see? Quantifiable. Right? That means you must know the quantity of what you want. So somebody, you know, somebody, they say, Dr. Barani, I want to be rich after I join Destina One. Now, this is the most non-logic statement. Do you know this is the most non-logic statement? You know why? They say, I want to be rich. What is rich to some people? What is rich to some people? You know, $1,000 is also rich. $10,000 is also rich. You see? $100,000 is also rich. $1 million is also rich. What do you want? What do you want? Quantifiable, right? You must have a quantifiable goal in a practical sense when you start your journey with Destina One. So let's say you want a Mercedes. A Mercedes is a German-made luxury car. But a Mercedes can cost 1,000, 200,000, 300,000. Which Mercedes you want? 100,000, 180,000? That quantifiable destination or goal, your journey again become very confusing. Without that, I'll tell you, give me a minute. Huh? Somebody, my God. Mr. Raj. Oh, your microphone. Okay. So remember, without a quantifiable mindset, your destination, your journey become very confusing. Very confusing. Even you don't know what to do. You don't know what kind of Mercedes that you want to buy. You see, somebody told me, I want to make $1 million. That's my goal. Fantastic. I want to make $1 million. $1 million. $1 million. That's my goal. Fantastic. That's a quantifiable goal. You see, quantifiable goal. That means you know that 1 0 0 0 0 0 0 0. You know the denomination 0 0 0 0. You know what is the amount. I want to make multi-$1 million. That's not quantifiable. I want to make $10 million, $20 million. You know that? Oh, 20 million. It's a quantifiable goal. You see, this is something very important. Sitting right there now, first stage of your journey in traditional business or Destina One, network marketing, is having a quantifiable goal, and don't be afraid. Don't be afraid of it. Don't keep it as a secret. Write it on your mirror. Let your mother see. Let your mother see that. Let your father see that. Let your family member see that. Write it on a mirror. I want to earn $1 million in this many years. $10 million in this many years. Don't be afraid. Don't keep it as a secret. Right? So every time you see that, you know what you really want in life. That's why I have a goal card, you know, goal setting card. You used to write down a goal setting card. Keep it in your pocket, and every time you can see what you want, how much you want to make in Destina One, how many people that you want to sign up a day, what you want to do in your life. The goal setting card is important. Right? So what I'm trying to tell you here, right, the most important thing, if you don't see what you really want in life, then you don't know where you are heading to. You need a quantifiable goal. So now let's take $1 million. Let's take $1 million. There's a three important things that I want to tell you all today. Depends on what kind of lifestyle that you want to lead, what kind of lifestyle that you need. You see? So stage one is quantifiable goal. Very easy. Very easy. Right? This is what you all need to do. Stage two, time. It's time. Now, this thing I'm going to talk to you all today, that we will all live until we are 100 years. Do you think we all will live until 100 years? It's a myth. It doesn't exist. You can drop dead tomorrow, or you can drop dead 6 months or 1 year or 200 years from now. I don't know. But you need first the quantifiable goal, right? And next, you need to know how long before you reach that goal. We don't have a time. We know that we want to make $1 million, but you don't set the time. How long I want to reach that 1 million? You see? This is something important. You know how intensively you need to work, how aggressively you need to work. And don't tell me you want to make $1 million in 2 days in network marketing. Please don't come and tell me. Don't waste your time. Don't waste my time also. But if you tell me that, Dr. Barney, in the next 1 year, I want to make $1 million. Is that overambitious, realistic, or conservative? $1 million in 1 year, which category that is for? Overambitious, realistic, or conservative? It's hard for us to decide. You know that it's also hard for us to decide. When you cannot decide which category it falls, what do? You look for an example of people who have done it before. Check which category it falls under. So talk to your upline, talk to me. I will tell you that there have been few people, maybe hundreds, 200s of people, maybe thousands of people in the world who have made, or there have been large number of people who have made $1 million in 1 year. Now, what does that say to you? That it is possible. It is possible, right? That's all you need to know. As long as you know it is possible, then you are on the right journey. So let's rewind this topic, this video a little bit. Let's rewind this video a little bit. Right? First, you starting your journey, you get a clear, quantifiable goal, $1 million in a year. And you say, 1 year, is that an acceptable time limit? Yes. Is that an acceptable time limit? Based on the example? Based on the example, yes. Hundreds of people, thousands of people have made it. $1 million in 1 year. So it is an acceptable time limit based on the example you have seen around. Example, success stories. Example that you have heard from your upline about common men and a common woman with an uncommon dream who made $1 million in 1 year. Good. Now everything is set in place. Now you can change 1 million to 100,000. Is that possible? Many people have done it. First we ask, can I make $1 million in 1 year? Is that possible? Yes, there are a lot of success stories. My upline said yes. My upline has made it. Dr. Barney has made it. So many people have made it. Yes, that means it is possible. But now let's change the $1 million to $100,000 in a year. Is that possible? Yes, many people have done it. If you can change $100,000 to $10,000 right, that means thousands of people have done it in network marketing and in Destina One. So whatever goal you choose, the smaller the goal, the more conservative the goal, more proof. The more over ambitious the goal, less proof. Right, simple theory of life. Now people get motivated when they see more proof. They get only motivated when they see more proof. When they see less proof, they go like, oh my God. Let's take, for example, the 100 meter. Let's take a simple example. Huh? The 100 meter. Who's the 100 meter? The Olympic man. Usain Bolt. Right? Usain Bolt, who have broken the holding world record today, right? He broke and holding a world record about 9 seconds. 9 seconds plus, right? Around there. Right? There's only one man who have reached that time limit. That's Usain Bolt. Anyone who wants to beat that record has only one person to prove. Now, for me, can you run the 100 meter in 1 hour? Yes or no? I think we all can run the 100 meter in 1 hour, right? Millions of people can run the 100 meter in 1 hour. Right? Give me a minute. Give me a minute. Sorry, very sorry, very sorry. They all love to see their own face side by side, having so many videos and cameras. Right? Now, let me ask you. Usain Bolt have run the 100 meter in 9 seconds. Right? Only one person have proved that. That's Usain Bolt. But can we all run the 100 meter in 1 hour? Yes. Very easy. Very easy. 100 meter in 1 hour. Yes, correct. Millions of people have done it. So is that goal achievable? High possibility. But to run 100 meter in less than 9 seconds, not high possibility. That would fall under over ambitious category. Now, in your journey in network marketing, in Destina One, when you have that goal of $1 million and you start your journey in 1 year, here comes the problem. All right? Here comes the problem. Or here comes the challenge. People are going to watch you like a hawk. You know, we used to tell that, hey, I'm going to achieve in 1 year, $1 million. Too overambitious. Possible, but less proof. Possible, but less proof. People have made it in 1.5 years, 2 years. Yes, there are a lot of proof. 3 years, many people. 4 or 5 years, yes, more people, right? But in 1 year, there is less proof. But yes, you will take that as a challenge and you say, I'm going to make it in 1 year in Destina One. Can you see that? But what happened? Remember, people are watching you. People are watching you like a hawk. People are going to observe you. They're observing you. Because when you announce to all your downlines like a hero, I'm going to make $1 million in 1 year from now. I'm going to make $1 million from 1 year from now. After 1 month and after 1 year, you make $10 or zero. Now you're under pressure. Or you make $250 or $300 or $400, $500 on third month or fourth month. Because you say 1 year. So you need to complete another $990,000 for you to reach that 1 million, right? So now you see you're under pressure. So you are under pressure, correct? After 2 months, you make $250 or whatever, pressure again. $300, pressure again. Because you need to make the balance $900 or $1,000 in another few more months. You see? So what happened? Suddenly this goal is no longer achievable. And under the pressure of making money, not achieving systematically goals to reach your ultimate goals, what happened to you? You become demotivated. You become scared. You become fearful. You become embarrassed. So now you are starting to hide yourself because your downline asking you, hey, have you made $1 million or not? Have you reached to that level or not? Have you reached at least $500,000 or not? So networkers lives in a very pressured environment. Very pressured environment because of the goal or destination or dream they want to achieve, and suddenly it become nothing. Reason why? Because they don't give a proper time. Even you marry, you want to have a baby. God decide, there's a time. Even your wife want to deliver to that baby, you need so many months. You cannot say, oh, you're pregnant now, make sure next month you deliver the baby. No way. You have to give some time for that, right? So to achieve your dream, you have also have to give some time. You see? So this is something important, right? Remember, your downlines are watching you. Your family members are watching you. Your mother-in-law is watching you. Your father-in-law is watching you. Everybody is watching you. Your mother-in-law is going to ask you, you know, hey, have you made $1 million or not? Have you done it or not? Can you see that? So remember. So my question to you is, answer yourself. Who are you doing it for? Who are you doing it for? Are you doing it for public? Are you doing it for people? Are you doing it for your downline, for your upline, for your mother-in-law, for your father-in-law, for your parents? For whom? You are doing it for yourself. That's important. Who are you doing it for? So if I announce $1 million in 1 year, if I announce $1 million in 1 year, all that's Dr. Barney's dream. Is that Dr. Barney's dream? No, it's your birthright. That's your goal. That's what you want to achieve. Right? That's what you want to achieve. And the whole world said to say, will wait to see you fail. Remember, I'm telling you the truth. I'm telling you the fact of life. The whole world said to say, you know, they will wait to see you fail. You know why? Society has reached a point where when you announce your dream, they all wait to see you fail. Even your closest friend, your neighbor, your own family members. Because society today hates successful people. Do you realize the most successful you become, the more people don't like you? They see you differently. You know why? They see you what they couldn't be. They see you what they wanted to be, what they want to achieve, but they never achieve. So when first clear, you must clear your mind, be a crystal clear what you are doing it and for whom you are doing it. For whom you are doing it? You are doing it for yourself. You know, I'll tell you this, 2-3 days, there's one incident happened. I don't mind to share this matter. It's my own family member. It's my own family member. They don't like to see that I'm so successful. My family is so successful. They don't like. They're being so jealous. And the good part is what? They're calling me and fighting with me. They're fighting with me. Do you know that? Even Arul was there beside me yesterday. They're fighting with me, you know. Oh, you're so successful. How come? How you're so very rich? You're doing great. So many people are changing their life because of you. Oh, I'm also very rich. You know, I also got big bungalow. You know, I got this, I got that. They even don't like your own family members. Can you see that? So we are thinking what, you know, sometimes, of course, not everyone, but sometimes certain family members, they feel so happy. Wow, my brother, my sister are very successful in their life. But some family members, no. I mean, 70% of the family member, they were like in front of you, like, oh, yeah, you're good, you're good. I'm happy for you. God bless you. But at the back, don't know what this fella is doing. I think he's doing something illegal business. That's why he's very successful. You know, I went through all this. And you know, when I was 20 years old, 20, 21 years old, I was driving 18 cars, right? You know, my own family members, you know what they say? Only I know the iceberg story. Only I know how hard work that I put. I work like a mad fellow to build the business. And you know what they say? I think this fellow is supplying heroin so I can become very rich. I think he's doing some under business thing, you know. That's why he can drive 18 cars, you know. No, you don't know, you know. Can you see that? Your own family members, I'll tell you. So I'll tell you one thing. Let me tell you one thing. Don't bother about all these people. If you are achieving this dream or goal for yourself, that's your personal dream, your personal vision, something you have dreamt about since you was a little child riding a bicycle, then it's between you and yourself. No need to worry about what other people are going to talk, what other people are going to comment, what other people are going to say. No need to bother. It's your dream, it's you and yourself. Do not allow people outside that circle of trust to affect you, to demotivate you, to distract you. You know that? I've seen so many networkers who quit from D1. And I ask them, why did you quit from D1? Well, Dr. Barani, I announced my goal to everyone and I didn't achieve it. After that, I was so embarrassed. I lost respect. People was laughing at me. You know, they are laughing at me. I said, they are laughing at me. Can I tell you something? Then you shouldn't have been a networker to being with. You shouldn't be in a networker. You should sell ice cream or lollipop or popcorn beside the roadside. Shouldn't be a networker. You see? But I guarantee you, if there's one business where everyone is going to laugh at you, is in D1, they will start laughing at you. They'll start laughing at you. So don't bother and don't worry about them. You know, 27 years ago, when I started my journey, everyone laughed at me. You know, my ambition, my vision, I used to tell, when I was 6 years old, I still remember, what is your ambition? I want to be in the top 10 richest men in the world. World richest man, top 10 list. I've seen, personally seen people like, man, you are a mad fella. Come on out to be a richest man, top 10 richest man in the world. But now, today, they are seeing me. I'm going to that stage. And they're respecting me. You know, remember, you start your journey, everyone laugh at you. Don't worry about them because you're doing it for yourself, not for other people. Because it's you and money. It's you and money. Money and you. You see? Right? Today, the same people who laugh at me, when they see me, you know what they say? Good morning, sir. So you're so successful. Can you share your tips? Can you share your secret of success? You know you have achieved your dreams and everyone calls you sir, including your family members. So you want a measurement when you have achieved financial freedom. It's when you wake up in the morning in your house, you come up from your room and your family members stand there and tell, good morning, sir. That means you have made it. So the people who laugh at you will always be there in every aspect of your journey in D1. Because the bigger your dream, more people laugh at you. The smaller dreams, nobody will laugh at you. If you say, my dream in 1 year to make $250, I guarantee you, you're going to achieve it. But I guarantee you, nobody is going to laugh at you if you never achieve it. You know why? Because your dream is smaller. Nobody bother about your dream because your dream is smaller. But when your dream is higher, people start to bother about you. People start to, wow, he's going to become success. Oh, I don't like. I feel jealous that he's going to become success. So that is the good force for you to become success. You see, I'll tell you one thing. Don't live in fear. I see a lot of networkers, they quit D1 in the early stage because they dream and they worried about what people talk about them. They worried about people laugh at them. So that's why they quit. They never quit because they cannot do this business. They said, such a beautiful product, beautiful marketing plan. I can achieve in this business. But the only challenge, Dr. Bharani, people are laughing at me because I never achieve it. Why you bother? Do you think when people laugh at you, they're going to come and give you money when you struggle, when you suffer, when you go through any kind of challenges? Do you think they're going to come and pay you? Do you think they're going to come and give you some money? Oh, Mr. Alex, I'm going to give you something. Oh, because you're struggling, please keep this $1 million. Do you think they're going to do that? So, I'll tell you, don't live in fear. Right? How people are going to react to you doesn't mean that you choose a journey or goal so small and insignificant just to avoid the ridicule and laughter of people. You know, some people, they just want to avoid this kind of issues. And they say, no, I better don't tell my dream to anyone. I just say, I'm going to earn $1,000 next week or next month or next another 1 month, 2 months or 3 months or in 1 year. Because if I'm going to tell a bigger dream, everyone is going to laugh at me if I cannot achieve it. Can you see that? So I'll tell you one thing, right? Richard Branson, Bill Gates, Sam Walton, Ananda Krishnan, Lim Gautam, Dr. Bharani, Professor Dr. Karunakaran. I'll tell you, I guarantee you one thing. When they started the journey, the whole world laughed at them. Do you know that? When I started my journey, the whole world laughed at me. My own family members laughed at me. I still remember. Even my own grandfather, my mother's uncle. When I go and talk to him about business, you know what he say? Hey, I've seen you from small baby and you're coming and talking to me $1 million. Go and do better job. But today, wow, look at my grandson. He is the most successful person in this family. He's the most successful person in this country. I'm so proud to say he's my grandson. Wow. How nice, huh? How nice. No, not only me. I believe all of y'all who are sitting there are going through the same problem. Right. So all these people, when they go through the same problem, right? If let's say they worried about the people that laugh at them, what happened to the world economy today? What happened to the world economy today? Hey, Lim Gautam, Ananda Krishnan, Bill Gates, Dr. Barani, Professor Karunakaran. When they started the journey, the whole world laughed at them. But today, the same group of people control the world economy. Control the world economy. The same group of people, if they decide to laugh, many countries go bankrupt. Do you know that? So, face the fact. This is a journey. It's your journey. If you have set a goal and you are serious about it, and this is something you want to achieve, this is something you need to achieve, this is something you have been thinking about as a child, don't worry what others think of. Because I rather not achieve my goal and let whole world laugh at me. I rather have to remain poor as nobody for the rest of my life. So you have the choice to make in your own business. You have the choice. Right? Tell you one thing. Let them laugh. Let them laugh. You keep going for your goal. You keep going for your goal. You miss in this year. Do it in next year. Fine. You said $1 million in this year. Fine, you missed it. Don't worry. Go it for next year. You missed it next year. Don't worry. Go it for the following year. You do it the following year. You missed it the next year. Don't worry. You're going for the next following year. Why you worry about that? Right? You missed it. Don't worry. You go for the next. You do it again. You do it again. You do it again. Until it becomes reality. Because every one of us who are today financially free went through the same exact journey. Do you think I born in this earth and immediately I become so rich? No. I went through the same journey. People laugh at me and I don't bother when people laugh at me. Because I wanted to achieve what I want. And when I cannot achieve in 1 year, I said, never mind. Postpone. Another one more year, I give time. Never mind. Another one more year. Never mind. Another one more year. Never mind. Another one more year. It's okay. I still remember about Don and Alex. Alex, I think, have given up more than, he already give up in Destina One more than, I think, 100 to 200 times. But his motivator is Don. You know what Don used to tell him? Brother Alex, it's okay. Don't give up. Maybe just give one more month time. Just one more month time. You never know what will change. Just one more month. Just give a try. Let's see. Even since you already spent so many months, just extra one more month, I think nothing is going to waste. So you better give one more month. So it's okay. I will give one more month. So he was doing that. Then he wanted to give up again. Said, never mind. You already spent about 7, 8, 9 months. It's okay. Give another one more month and see. So Don extend his life in Destina One. One more month, one more month, one more month, one more month, until that one more month today he's achieving it. He's doing very well. So he should thank Don. So remember the quality of the upline. The upline. Motivate your downline when they wanted to give up just because of other people. It's not because that I cannot do it. It's because of other people. Right? Other pressure. Motivate them. Motivate them. Remember, I'll tell you one thing. Do it again and again and again until it becomes a reality, because every one of us who are today financially free went through the same exact journey. But you cannot quit. You cannot be embarrassed to a point where you don't want to do it anymore. That you go back home and go back to that life, go back to work, come back home, go back to work, come back home, go back to work, come back home. For 40 years and die as a nobody, that's a decision you have to make for yourself. Right? If you have a strong enough desire to make the money, then do it whatever it takes. Pay the price, right? Pay the price for it. Let the world laugh. Let the world laugh. Don't bother. I guarantee you, at the end of your journey, you will be the one laughing. You will be the one laughing at the end of your journey. You know why? This is network marketing. Network marketing is a business. It's a business where you really make $1 million. I can guarantee you, I can give you a guarantee from the time you start your journey with D1 until you finish that journey. You will learn much more about yourself, about other people, about life than any university or any school can ever teach you. My journey of 27 years have taught me more than I've ever learned. I have the greatest teacher. I had the greatest teacher, you know, like my father was always beside me. And even my own downlines. Even my own downlines. You see, they taught me what is life about. You see, I will ever learn. Really, they taught me, my father, my downline. Even I learned from my downline. I don't say you are my downline, I didn't bother. I even learned from my downline, right? But I learned something. I never give up. I never give up. I learned, but I never give up. I never slowed down. I never slowed down because my destination was about me and my goal. It was money and me. It's something personal, which I won't allow people to slow me down. So remember one thing, you are moving along this journey and you are not achieving your goal, don't be panic. If you don't achieve your goal, don't be panic. Don't run and hide. Instead, find out. Find out why. I'm going to give you a few potential reasons why people achieve their goals in network marketing. Why people don't achieve their goal in network marketing. You see? We've created 1,705 millionaires. Why that 1,705 millionaires can become a millionaire? Why we all cannot become a millionaire yet? Why? The potential reason why people don't achieve their goals in network marketing. Why people don't achieve the success in network marketing, which they are supposed to. It's very simple. Huh? Simple. That's what my parents taught me from young. My parents taught me from young. If you are allergic to hard work, stay at home. Is that true? If you are allergic to hard work, stay at home. Stay at home, honestly, I'm telling you. Don't come out. Don't come out from the house. Stay at home, die broke, so that's it. Really, I'm telling you. In network marketing or any traditional business requires you to work hard. Work hard. There's no shortcut. Now, let me tell you, there's no shortcut. There's no special formula. There's no secret or formula or whatever. Trust me. 27 years, I never found it, honestly. I never found it. It requires you to work hard. Hard work, meeting your people, meeting your downline, training them. Hard work, sleeping less. Sleep less. Don't come and tell me, oh, not enough sleep per day. I need to sleep for 8-10 hours. Hard work, sacrificing your holidays. It's hard work waking up every morning when you don't feel like making it. Don't worry, sacrifice yourself. Have appointment on daily basis. Hard work. Call them for a coffee. Follow-up meetings. Hotel meetings. Showing the plan every day to a complete stranger in the bus stop. Yesterday, Madam JC was telling me, even people who's walking in the bus stop, I go and approach them. That's called hard work. We all are sitting in a comfort zone, you know. Say, oh, I should not approach any stranger. I only will approach the person that I know. Hard work, don't bother. They are also human one. They also need this product. They also need you. Go approach them. That's called hard work. You see, all of this is categorized into one thing called hard work. So most people who run away because they are not achieving their goals. They run away because they are not achieving their goals and say, I'm embarrassed. You know, in Malaysia, we call malu. Huh? We say malu, right? Malu. You know, we are embarrassed. About what? I'm not achieving my goal. People are laughing. Is that what? No. It's laziness. Let me tell you. Next thing is laziness. They know that even though people laugh at them, even they realize that they are doing for themselves, they don't bother about other people, because when you are struggling, when you are suffering, sorry, other people is not going to come and help you. So basically, it's laziness. No hard work. They keep giving reason. I went and met so many people, but this is really hard for me to see. What you're doing are rocket science. You're going to send the rocket to the moon. So simple, presentation, approach in a proper way, and love to give reason. Keep giving reason. Reason or results. Right? Reason or results. Correct? So I'll tell you one thing. It's more about laziness than embarrassment. Right? So if you can't work hard, stay at home. I'll tell you one thing, stay at home. D1 or network marketing, Destina One and network marketing as a whole in the industry, they are the biggest set in the industry, and you must be ready to work hard. You will work harder than you have ever worked in your life, but it is worth it. It is worth it. Second reason why people don't actually achieve their goal in time, because they don't take their goal seriously. They don't take their goal seriously. Right? I'm going to have one program called 7 days a week. 7 days a week. How many days in a week? Is that 8 days, 9 days, 10 days? 7 days only, right? 7 days a week. So I'm going to come up with this program, 7 days in a week. What you need to do every day. Every day for 7 days. I'm going to set a plan for you. 7 days a week, right? Now, remember, 7 days a week, it's a cycle of 7 days. 7 days decide how much money you make, how serious you take the business. Because if you only got 7 days to decide how much money you're going to make for that week, that's all. Somebody said, Dr. Barney, but we need a balanced life. I cannot spend my 7 days. Very true, very true. You need a balanced life. But wait until you be financially free. You have the most balanced life in this earth. Don't worry. You know, some people, they still come and talk to me. You have to work 7 days a week. Oh, Dr. Barodi, I need to balance my life. Vacation with the family, family day. Can. No problem. Don't worry. You can have all that. Wait until you financially free. You achieve that financial freedom, you can have the total, ultimate balanced life in this earth. No problem. You don't need to see Dr. Barney's face also after that. You can have a beautiful balanced life. Wait until you become financially free. Right? So I'll tell you one thing. Until you achieve that goal, you got to take your journey very seriously. That means every day counts. Every day counts, huh? Every day. Can proudly say I achieved my dream. Every day counts, huh? You can proudly say that I've achieved my dream when you follow these 7 days. I've made $1 million. I've made this. Is it possible? Who decides? Not your relative, huh? Who are laughing. Not your neighbor. Not your family members. Guys. It's all about you. It's money and me. You. Money and me, it's a personal relationship, you and your goal, you decide how you want to take it seriously. And the third potential reason is you don't know what to do. You start your journey, you have the goal, but your cup is full. The cup is full. You know, they know everything. They know the whole world. They just join, not even 1 month, but they become expert. Even never achieve to the top level, but they want to start edit the slide presentation. Oh, we need to add this. We need to add this. We need to add this. We need to bring this topic so people can grow really young. Once you become a decrowned diamond, then you do whatever you want. I'm not going to question you. I'm not going to question anybody. But before achieving it, follow. Why? There is a reason. It's not about we are giving less information. It's about we are not going to confuse people in the information that you're giving. More information, people get confused. Certain things which you need to do in a training, you're doing in a presentation. You know, I've seen that day, they're doing presentation. People only ask them to do presentation, right? What is color energy? 300 to 1,000 times healing power. My God, they take only 1 minute to just explain that word. 300 to 1,000 times healing power. You know what is healing power? You know this, you know that, you know this grandfather, this grandmother. They talk all kinds of stories. Come on, don't confuse the people. You do all these in a training. But as a leader, people ask to do training. They don't want to do training. They want to do all this in a simple presentation. Keep it short. Presentation must be keep it short. You know, if your cup is full, if your cup is full, you say, I know what I'm doing. Famous last word of all people who died broke. Okay, right. I know what I'm doing. If you know what you're doing, then you won't be in network marketing. You won't be in networking today. Anyway, you will be a Bill Gates, Warren Buffett, you'll be a Dr. Barney. There'll be somebody in your life. Right? Understand. So the fact that you are starting your journey and having a goal while riding a bicycle and wanting of Mercedes, that means your whole life you didn't know what you are doing. How to start out with this new journey? Now, when you start this new journey, do you know what to do? Do you know what to do? Okay. So, do you know what to do? So, please, there's another program called Empty Your Car. Empty your car. If you never empty your car, and if you keep saying that, I know how to do network marketing, I am expert, I know all this, or I'm doing the right way. So why you're not successful? Why you're struggling? Correct? So empty your car. Learn from your upline. Learn from your downline. Learn from your upline, learn from your downline, right? So, and also I'm going to do another program called Shut Up, Listen and Do. Honestly, I'm going to do that program. Very nice program. I think I've done that program one time, Arula, in our D1DS. Shut Up, Listen and Do. Seriously, if I don't know what to do, I will look at somebody who have done it and what I do? I just shut up. I just listen and do. I don't reinvent the wheel. So when I got into the business, I look at Professor Karuna and said, I want to be like this man, financially free. He has done. He has become so successful, so rich. So what I do? Shut up, listen and do. That's all. I don't reinvent the wheel. Simple. Once you become a crown diamond, then you can reinvent the wheel. Doesn't matter. You can come up with your own concept, own system, everything by your own. Because you know You have went through 10,000 hours, you have completed 10,000 hours, and you have met so many number of people, you have went through so many challenges, so you know what to talk, what not to talk, how to do, how not to do. So with that experience, when you become a crown diamond, you know how to handle it. Until that, I'm going to come up with this beautiful program called Shut Up, Listen and Do. Nice program, very nice program. A lot of people, they enjoy this program. Right? It's so simple. So if you don't know what to do, or your things, you are doing wrong things. You're doing wrong things. Then look for people who have done it the right way and just follow them. Just follow them. Just listen to them. Just listen to them. And you reach your destination very fast. Because they have went through the hurdles, the challenges. So they know how to protect you from not going and going through the same hurdles and challenges. They will protect you. So get their advice. Right? So I believe in everyone's life, no matter who you are. And what you need. But one important thing in our life, you need something which keeps you alive. Honestly speaking, you need something to keep you alive. Some reason, some things which keeps you breathing, something which keeps you alive, something which keeps you motivated. It's not only your dream. Do you think something which keeps you motivated is your dream? No, it's not only your dream. It could be your children. It could be your parents like me, my sister, my children. It could be your other people. I mean, and not only that, it could be a vision of helping mankind. We all always used to talk about this, right? That could be the simple reason, right? So, we are here to change many people's life. We are here to save many people's life. I believe this is one of the beautiful force which keeping us alive in this business. Because we wanted to achieve, we wanted to save people's life, and we wanted to save, change people's life. It's not about money alone. If money alone, of course, we will go through so many challenges and tend to give up. But I believe it's about changing people's life and saving people's life, which is holding us. You see, that is a force who's driving us. Right? So, there must be something which keeps the fire inside burning all the time. A lot of people don't have that fire. So until you find your fire, this journey may be meaningless. My fire is changing people's life and saving people's life. That's why even 4 o'clock in the morning today, I'm sitting and preparing a lot of things. Even though Arul was there, Mr. Raj was there, Mr. Perumal was there, they know, even though while traveling, I just take a nap. I said, no, I have to complete certain things. If other people, I need to have a proper sleep. Yes, you can have a proper sleep. Don't worry, until you reach financial free. Until you reach financial free. I'll tell you one thing. Take this as a challenge. Take this as a challenge. I'll tell you one thing. Take this as a challenge. Find your fire. You have to find your fire. If you don't have that fire, your journey is meaningless. So the fourth thing is make sure your journey has meaning, which is bigger than you. Which is bigger than you. Make sure your journey has powerful meaning behind it. That motivates you to wake you up in the morning. So remember that making money is okay. Having a desire for money, it's okay. Because money is not good. Money is not bad. People are good and people are bad. And one thing that Professor Karuna has created with the concept changing people's life and saving people's life, ultimately, this journey is between you and yourself. That's called hope for mankind. With the hope for mankind, we know that we can do a lot of charity, a lot of service, we can save many people's life, we can change many people's life. With that, take that as a drive. Take that as a fire. I'm here to change many people's life. I'm here to save many people's life. I will do it. Not for the world, for yourself. Right? I'll tell you one thing. This journey is between you and yourself. Don't let the world control you. Don't let other people control you. Don't let the lover of other people control you. People can talk whatever they want. Don't bother. Do it for yourself. Don't let the world demotivate you. Most importantly, don't let the will stop you. The willpower, the will stop you. You see? So quitting is not an option. So when you feel like giving up, do. When you feel like quitting, do. When you feel like running back home and hiding, don't. When you feel like running away, don't. Because it's about you. Ultimately, it's your life and your journey. If you have made the decision, stick by it, and that $1 million will become a reality. That's 100%. Stick with it. Don't run. You cannot achieve it, don't worry. Take some time to achieve it. Right? It will become reality. Because I've seen with my own two eyes, common man and common woman, do it every day in B1. I've seen people who have no education do it. I've seen people who are from small town have do it. I've seen nobodies have done it. You know, I've seen many housewives. I've seen many students. I've seen many professors, engineers, lawyers. I've seen all kind of people doing it in the Destina One. If they have done it, then you can do it. But ultimately, it's your personal journey. So find that crystal clear, quantifiable goal. Decide on time, period that you want to achieve it based on what you have seen. People, example out there. If they achieve 1 year, so I also can achieve 1 year. If they achieve in 2 years, I also can achieve 2 years. You have never seen anyone achieve in 2 months? Don't come and tell me, I'm going to achieve in 2 months, Dr. Barney. Oh my God. Please don't do that. Right? I'll tell you one thing. Take your journey seriously. Don't be afraid. No need to be afraid. Why to be afraid? Right? You want to make $1 million. Announce it to the world. Nothing wrong with it. The whole world keeps telling you that. You shouldn't be materialistic and greedy. Right? People say, don't be materialistic and greedy. Teacher Grace, don't worry about them. Only poor people tell you that. Don't be materialistic and greedy. Do you realize that Bill Gates, do you think he will come and tell you, don't be materialistic and greedy? Do you think he will say that? I don't think so. Bill Gates will come and say that. Do you think Ananda Krishna will tell that? I don't think Ananda Kinson will tell you that. Even Dr. Barney will tell that. Because people who have made in their life will always tell you to make it in your life. When they made it in their life, they will always tell you that you also have to make it. They won't say, don't be materialistic, don't be greedy, no need money, stay broke, just ride a bicycle, settle your life. No. People have made it will always tell you, you also have to make it. Simple message from me, money and me. That's a simple message. All right. It's your journey. It's between you and yourself. Take it seriously. And my only advice is don't ever quit. Don't ever think of quitting the business. Don't even ever have the mindset come and disturb you that I better quit. I better give up. Don't. Because ultimately, it's you and your money. Remember that. Right? So anyway, thank you very much to all. Thanks for your time. Right? The next program, the next Founders Friday is going to be, I'm thinking about it 7 days a week, or maybe shut up, listen and do, or empty your cup. Let me see what I can do for y'all. So it's going to be a wonderful program. And it's a very meaningful program. And you will really learn a lot of things. And when you learn and make sure you grab it and you use it and you do it. Right? So thank you very much. Thanks to all of y'all. Destina One, world number one. 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 Can all of y'all unmute your microphone? Come quick. Let's do it faster.
Destina One.
Destina One, world number one. Destina One, world number one. Destina One, world number one. Thank you. Thank you. Have a good day. Bye bye.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.